I decided to study my PhD when I was doing my my research in my master's studies. That at that time, it was for me, it was the first experience I have to research a certain topic and to have the chance to draw the track of this and the path of this research topic. So I was so excited doing that research, and I had, back then, I had some ideas to share. So by the end of my master, by finishing my master studies, I decided to share these ideas to a broader audience. So I contacted some people from the UK, and they suggested more ideas to do. At the end, I decided to do it as a PhD. Now in my PhD, I have some chapters, and each chapter is just one idea that I want to share with other people and experts in the field. My PhD research is about assessing the losses in the water distribution networks. So in my work, I am doing some analysis for the leakage in the network, the leaks and breaks in the network. And I also do some analysis for non-physical losses, like the customer meters inaccuracies. All customer meters are not accurate. So we analyze the accuracies of the customer meters, the water meters. And then we also do a lot of work in the field for leakage estimation, leakage modeling, leakage reduction scenarios, and yeah, this kind of things. My plans after I become a doctor and I finish my PhD research is I'm not decided yet, but I can it would be a good opportunity for me here to sharpen my experience here in the Dutch context and to gain more knowledge in the practice in the field. And then after some years, I can go to Yemen, my own country, and to help our people there to develop the countries and help our people there with development and peace. My recommendation for a new PhD fellows is, first is motivation. PhD, one of my colleagues says, PhD is a very long journey, and sometimes it is a lonely journey as well. When you search a certain topic for several years, and you are, they say, the only one who goes as deep as that. So my recommendation is motivation. You need, or he needs, to be motivated enough to do this topic, to research this topic for, let's say, 5 years or 4 years, and then sometimes, or most likely, for the rest of his life, professional life, what I mean. So motivation is really, really important. Patience is really important about the topic in general. And then second, they should try to, let's say, surround themselves with people who push them up, yeah? Because PhD is ups and downs. So sometimes you need people around you to push you up. So it is better, even if you are independent, even if you can work individually, it's a good idea to involve more people in your work and to involve more partners. Sometimes partners from the fields, from the practitioners in the fields are really good. They give you some insights. They give you some experience, and they give some ideas. And sometimes going to the field and the practitioners in the field is something rewarding. So first is motivation. Second is partners. And then it's PhD is not, let's say, a destination, it is a journey. They say, one colleague of me said that there is only two types of PhD, finished and unfinished. So sometimes the more you research a topic, the more questions you have to answer. So you will add chapter after chapter, and then this has to be finished, or let's say this process has to be ended at some time. So try to be specific and to limit yourself with something doable. And second, it is my own experience. The more I research a certain topic, the more it becomes uncertain. Yeah, the more you go deep in the topic, the more you realize the limitations of the work, the more you realize that there is no absolutely true answer for any question of your research. And this is the process that we should learn in our PhD. Yeah, it's not only the skills the modeling skills or researching skills. It's also a process. So time management is a really crucial issue in this, and deciding when to stop your PhD is also good. Otherwise, some people will take it very long PhDs. And yeah, I wish them good luck. It's a very exciting experience.